Hi viewers, today I'm going to be showing you how to charge a car's AC system or the process for recharging automotive car air conditioning. This AC system is already empty, so I'll be showing you how to recharge an AC system from empty to full charge. There are two main ways to recharge a car AC system. First is by weight, second is by pressure. Recharging by weight is usually preferred. Recharging by pressure is dependent on a whole lot of variables, ambient temperature, as well as the relative humidity. A lot of people consider only ambient temperature, but then relative humidity also plays a part if you're recharging by pressure. So the best way to do it is to go by weight, and that's what I'm going to be demonstrating today. I'm going to be showing you some of the minimum set of tools that I use or you can use to pull off recharge by weight effectively. Now let's get this. Before starting to recharge your AC system, one of the first things you would want to consult is this sticker. Is usually found somewhere under the hood, and it tells you the refrigerant type, the recommended charge, that's the weight of refrigerant that you're going to use, as well as the oil type, the oil that will go into the compressor and the AC system in general. Very important, always consult this. If your sticker is missing, there are websites that you could use to quickly check the recommendation for your car. The tools you're going to need, first of all, manifold gauge, of course, refrigerant gas. So I use this brand, it's called HAP, I swear by HAP. Also, you would need compressor oil. So there are different types of compressor oil. Mine uses oil 8 or ND8, some there's ND9 and a whole bunch of other oils. Also important, because I'm measuring by weight, I'm leveraging a 5 kg scale. I've used it in the past, pretty accurate, works well. Safety glasses or safety goggles, not absolutely essential, but I advise you have this. It's a valve core remover, just in case you need to remove one of your valves. You would need some means of measuring the compressor oil, so I tend to use a syringe. Any other thing that you could use that would give you appropriate or precise measurements would be acceptable. Lastly, you would need a vacuum pump. This is one vacuum pump that I've used over the years. It's proved very good, pulls the vacuum, and it's lasted over the years. It's value brand out of China. I'll leave a link in the description just in case you want to get this. Again, I know you may be saying that's a lot of tools required for this, but this is what you need to do the job properly. I know there are recharge kits you could use to recharge your system, but the truth is, if your AC system is empty, you need to pull a vacuum. You must have to pull a vacuum if you want your AC system to continue to last. So the first thing to do is to hook up your manifold gauge. I have it on this latch. You want to make sure that they are closed. This is closed as well. Then you go ahead to identify your service ports. Usually the larger one is the high side, the smaller one is the low side. You remove the caps, and then you go ahead to attach your couplers. These are attached to the manifold gate. Red is high side. The way you attach it, you pull this back and then press it all the way, then release. That sits in. Same goes for the low side. You pull this back and then press that in. Give it a tug, make sure it's tight. So as I said before, this system is empty. As you can see, both the high side and the low side are reading zero pressure. Again, you want to make sure that here is well screwed on so that you don't have any leaks, either when you're vacuuming or when you're adding refrigerant. So just giving you the complete picture, you have this through the lines. Yellow line is the vacuum line, that's where we'll add refrigerant from, and that's where we'll pull our vacuum from, and then the other two go into the service ports right there. The next thing to do is to pull a vacuum on the system. So you unscrew this cap and attach the other end of the vacuum line to this. So make sure that's snug, the O-rings will do the job. Next, you want to pull up this cap slightly, that should do, and then go ahead to turn on the vacuum pump. With the vacuum pump on, you go ahead to open the gauges, the two sides. So as you can see, this is almost at 30 inches of mercury. It's impossible to pull a perfect vacuum on Earth. Again, very solid vacuum pump. So you want to vacuum this for a minimum of 30 minutes. What that does, it takes out air. It takes out moisture. Those two things are what you don't want in an AC system, because the air and the moisture are going to react with the refrigerant to form acid. The acid will go on to eat away on the linings and other components of the AC system and you spring a leak. So it's now been more than 30 minutes since we turned this off. I'll shut off these valves. Same goes for this one. Turn this off. So you want to observe this for a minimum of 2 hours to ensure that there isn't any leak. If you record a drop in vacuum, which is the needle moving that way, then you know there's a large leak that would need to be repaired. If there's no drop in vacuum, then that's good. Means no large leaks. Doesn't mean you couldn't have smaller leaks, but then you don't have any large leaks. So after 2 hours, the needle hasn't dropped. The next thing to do is to add oil to the system. You never recharge an AC system without adding oil. Different car manufacturers have different recommendations for adding oil. For this particular car I'm working on, you need to add 25 mils of compressor oil. Your car may be different. I'll leave a link to where you can find what quantity of oil to add. I'm going to be adding compressor oil to my vacuum line, and I need 25 mils. Bear in mind, this is hygroscopic, so you don't want to leave this oil open. As soon as you draw out what you need, you want to cover it quickly so that it doesn't get contaminated by moisture. Basically, chuck this in here and begin to squirt your oil inside. It's a bit messy. Depending on how much volume you're supposed to add back to the system, you may or may not encounter the ugly scenario where the line gets filled with oil. That's 10 mils in. I'll go ahead to add the rest. Basically, what I'm saying is that you may get to a point where it's almost as if this is filled. Then you would need to tilt this other end so that the oil goes down while you elevate this other end that you're going to be adding oil from, and just continue that until you're able to add all the volume that you're required to add. Next is to connect the charge line to the can of refrigerant. So one other thing I do before I start charging, hold this can pipe assembly vertically, agitate the pipe, and that's basically to try and send all the bubbles to the top. Connect the charge line to your manifold gauge. So the next thing we're going to do is to bleed air from the charging line. Open up this valve. So we head to the other end. We loosen this just a bit until you start hearing gas coming out. So we just want to remove the air. And that's it. Before you start charging, you want to weigh your refrigerant. So starting from this first can, this is weighing 383. So that's the starting weight. We're basically going to be charging through the blue side, which is the low side. It's not advisable to hook up these small cans to the high side. So we go ahead to open this. The vacuum is going to suck the oil in as well as the gas too. So you go ahead to agitate the can. So you rotate from 12 o'clock position to 3 o'clock. So, and to tell you that refrigerant is leaving the can, it's going to get really cold. This has gotten cold already. And you're doing all of this with the engine off first. So you're going to get in some refrigerant. I'm not getting much change in volume, so it's time to turn on the car and turn on the AC as well. Turn off the circulation, wind down the glasses a bit, turn on the AC, and should be on full blast, and then continue adding the refrigerant. So right now this can is feeling empty, it's no longer cold to touch. I'll go ahead to weigh the can. 193. So that means we need to add an additional 360 grams to come up to 550, which is the target charge. This can do with anywhere between 500 to 550, and a new can is 340. So I'm just going to add this entire new can. That should bring us up to about 530 grams. That should be good. So go ahead and attach the new can. So that's firmly in place. Hook up the charging cable. Next, go ahead to pierce the can. You'll feel a give once this pierces. Then you open that back up again. That's bleeding the air out of the system. And then you go ahead to tighten it again. So as you can see, the AC compressor has kicked in. That's why the low side is low and the high side is high. So I'll go ahead to open up this. Gently, and just continue agitating the can as usual. Just to say that while you're charging, you should keep your eye on this spyglass. If the rate you're going at is too much, you're going to see liquid refrigerant is going to fill up this chamber, which you don't want, because you don't want to add liquid refrigerant into the system, just the gas. So right now, these are what the gauges are looking like. On the low side, I have 60, and on the high side, 280, thereabout, which looks good. I'm not charging by pressure anyway, but just to show you what the pressure is looking like. I've now finished this can. It's no longer feeling cold, and there's nothing inside there anymore. It's practically empty now. So it's advised you turn it upside down and wait for a couple seconds just for the system to suck out all the refrigerant. And I'll go ahead to shut this valve. There you have it, guys. I have the AC on full blast. It's on recirculation mode, and as you can see, the temperature inside of the vehicle is at 20 degrees centigrade. Outside is a hot 38 degrees centigrade. That's a difference of 18 degrees. So this is chilling really nicely. Shut the car off. Remove the couplers. Remove the high side. Usually, that's the sound you'd get. You screw that on as well. That's how to recharge your car AC system by weight. If this video was helpful, give this video a thumbs up, give it a like and share as well, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much for watching. See you on the next one. Peace out.